It's Jennifer Batza here of Belladonna's Botanicals. I wanted to talk to you a little bit. I don't know, some of you may have seen the blog post I made on our website about some of the issues I'm having right now with my suppliers for Belladonna leaf and European mandrake. The two suppliers that I've been using for the past since I started making stuff are either out of stock or, I don't know when it's going to be back in stock. One of them is in Europe. I usually get my belladonna from Spain. And the reason I get it from the same place is because I know, there's consistency there from where it's grown and stuff, that it's not going to wildly vary from batch to batch. So now the issue in this is, and before anyone says, oh, well, just grow your own, a couple things. I live in a city. I live in a row home. I do not have a lot of space to grow. I did try to grow some stuff last year. I converted my guest bathroom into sort of a poison garden bathroom for a while. Didn't really work out very well. I ended up with aphids, which is sort of like these little insecty parasitic insect things that are common with nightshades. But anyways, I gave a lot of the surviving plants and stuff and seeds I gave to a friend, and that you have to kind of, because I'm not that great at growing things, and with running the business I have to kind of put things in, priorities, and I can't really grow in the quantities in which I use things. I just don't have the space for it. And also, I've been dealing with for the past year some physical chronic pain issues and joint mobility issues. And, crawling around in the dirt is not something I really want to throw my body into right now. I'm midway in the process of, excuse me, of getting the nerve ablation in my lumbar spine. So they did the left side. I'm getting the right side done in a few weeks. Anyways, that aside, I just don't have the space, the time, nor the physical capacity really to grow my own herbs. I would love to. I don't live on a farm. I live in the city. I mean, I'm in a block of, row homes. And it's I don't I either I just don't have the wherewithal to do it. So that's why I've relied on particular farms and suppliers to where I've bought in bulk before. Now it got to the point, because I just assumed that, the places I bought things from, like as recently as over the summer, would that there'd be no issue. But there's an issue, and I don't know when and if and when they're going to be back in stock. Now, what this means is that what I have, the products I have, mostly flying ointments and one tincture that include belladonna and mandrake. What I have in stock is what I have in stock. I do not know at this point when I'm going to be able to restock them. I do have a very small amount of belladonna left that I'm going to hold on to. I might be able to kind of, depending on, I have to weigh out and see just exactly how much I've left. So I might be able to kind of, make some very small batches of things to kind of fill in the gaps. But it's gonna be on a priority basis. So whatever I have in stock right now is what I have in stock. Until I can find new suppliers, it is not easy to find suppliers for such things. European mandrake is particularly difficult to grow, and it is also particularly difficult to cut. It's a very thick wood, the roots are. Now, what you'll see in a lot of stores, things that are called mandrake root, which is actually not mandrake root, it's American mandrake root, which is an entire different genus and species. It's not even a nightshade. It's not even in the same family. It doesn't even have the same qualities or effects to it. It's actually a purgative. So if you want to puke your brains out, go ahead. So that's the majority of the mandrake. So you have to be really careful that you're getting a true European mandrake root. Yeah. So with that said, I am working with a friend to see because the one that I give the plants to, I think they have some belladonna root, but even so, if we're gonna kind of do some, growing exchange sort of thing, it's gonna take some time, obviously, because I'm in Pennsylvania, so we are entering the w dreary winter months, so nothing is growing here, and most people can't really afford to, have indoor greenhouses or have the space for an indoor greenhouse in the city. I know it would cost me probably thousands of dollars to convert, a chunk of my basement to a greenhouse. So, that aside, once I do start getting some belladonna root and leaf back into stock, I'm gonna have to test, its potency to see how it works in. Like it'll work, probably will work fine in like the tinctures and the flying ointments, but if it's root, it's not going to work in the Diabolica smoke blend, which actually I'm already sold out of. So, but everything else is kind of what it is. I do have plenty of other ointments that don't have European mandrake or belladonna. I have many that have Romanzia and Datura stramonium and Datura anoxia. I have, well, the fly agaric mushroom one has the flying ointment has mandrake root in it, but I might be able to reformulate that one just to keep it because that's one of my most popular ones. So I might reformulate some things over time. Or release a couple, where I know I have a regular supplier for Datura, or I have enough in stock, and same thing with Bronzia, I might be able to release some new things within that area. But as far as like the belladonna stuff goes and European mandrake, it's just kind of question mark for now. Now I do have a lot of things in stock at this point in time. I'll put a link below to the blog post with the particular products. I know it was the Diabolica smoke blend, and the only tincture of I do have some tinctures on clearance that have belladonna and mandrake in it, but I had already, what I have is what I have, and those are marked down. The Fly to the Witch's tincture and elixir was one that but I think I just made new batches of it like a couple months ago, so I have plenty of that in stock right now. Flying ointment wise, that would affect the Asmodeus, Astarte, Ave Satanas, Azazel, Belial, Bella Blue, Beyond the Matrix, Flying High in the Sheets, Go Ask Alice, Hecate, Hedge Witch, King Paimon, Lilith, Liminal States, Lucifer, Lucifuge Raphael, Medusa, Sex Magic, Spirit Communication, and the Morgue and Flying Ointments. So, yeah. So those are the products that right now are affected by it. So I just wanted to make a quick update about that, just so I have the information out there. And if anyone has any questions, if you have any resources, let me know. And not seeds either, because like I said, I'm not great at growing things and I don't have the space to. I can't do all the things. I wish I could. What if I could, but I can't. I'd love to own a farm someday, but yeah, that's not in the cards for 2022 or 2023 at this point. So, be that as it may, thanks so much for watching, and I will continue to post some updates when I have them regarding the product stock that I have, or if anything's back in stock, or if there's any new releases. So, anyways, thanks for watching.